Assalamu alaikum, dear students. During the last lecture of cell division, we learned about the formation of new cells by process of mitosis and meiosis. And during both the processes, very important event was the duplication of the chromosomes. So during the mitosis, division at the centromere resulting in the sister chromatobe separation, and result is the 46 chromosome new of cells. And in case of meiosis, it is the separation of the member of the pairs during the meiosis one. More important, another very important event which occurs during the meiosis one is the synapse formation and the crossing over of the genetic material. All these events may lead to some of the chromosomal abnormalities. And a chromosomal abnormality may reflect in the form of the problem with the number of the chromosomes in the new cells, or with the problem with the structure of the chromosome in the new cells. So the numerical abnormalities is when the resulting cell does not contain the number of the chromosomes which is to be required. For example, after the mitosis, it should be the 46 chromosome in the new cells as in the parent cell. And in case of the meiosis, the number should be reduced. It should be 23. And when a chromosome is missing, either a chromosome from a pair or has more than two chromosomes of a pair, then it is labeled as the numerical abnormalities. And typical example is the Down syndrome, which is actually the syndrome with the cells containing an extra copy of the chromosome number 21. So every cell now contains 47 chromosomes rather than the 46, and due to the an extra copy of the chromosome number 21. Sometimes the resulting cells may contain less number of the chromosome than the parent one. Then, for example, if the resulting cell contains one chromosome less than the parent, then it is called the monosomy, as some of the pair does not contain the two member, it may contain the one member of a particular pair. Typical example is the Turner syndrome, which is an example of the monosomy, where the individual in this case is born with a single X chromosome. She is female, so the X chromosome, the sex chromosome, does not is present in the form of a pair, rather one member is short. Structural abnormalities: when the chromosome structure is altered, this can take place in several forms. For example, deletion, a portion of the chromosome is missing or deleted. Duplication, a chromosome is duplicated, resulting in an extra genetic material with specific to that chromosome number. Translocations, it may be of two types, the reciprocal or the Robertsonian. Reciprocal is also called the balanced one, and the Robertsonian also called the unbalanced one. When a portion of the one chromosome is transferred to another chromosome, and that exchange may be balanced one. If it is a balanced one, that a specific amount of the genetic material is transferred from one to another, and the in response the same amount is transferred to the number one, then it is called the reciprocal translocation or the balanced translocations. In a Robertsonian translocation or the unbalanced, an entire chromosome has attached to one another at the centromere. For example, Down syndrome. or sometime immature portion is detached from one chromosome and get attached to the another, and in response it gets very less amount of the DNA from the other partner. The Down syndrome, for example, when the long arm of the chromosome number 14 get detached from its original chromosome and get attached to the long arm of the chromosome number 21. The translocations are most common in the chromosome number 13, 14, 15, 21 and 22nd number chromosomes. These are the chromosomes which reflects the translocation problems. Another structural abnormality is the inversion. A portion of the chromosome has broken off, turned upside down and get reattached to the same chromosome. So now the sequence of the gene is changed. Genetic material remains there on that specific, but the sequence is now changed. So it may also reflect in the abnormalities in the transcription. A portion of the chromosome has broken off and formed a circle or a ring. That is called ring forms chromosome. This can happen with or without the loss of the genetic material. Most chromosomal abnormalities occur as an accident in the formation of the ovum of the sperm. So the abnormality is present in every cell, because if a defective ovum or a sperm get fertilized with the other gamete, the zygote will be containing the 47 chromosome or the 45 chromosome. So every cell resulting from the zygote will contain the 47 or the 45 chromosome. So these numbers will be present in each and every cell of the body. Some abnormalities, however, can happen after conception, resulting in mosaicism, where some cells have the abnormality and some do not. For example, zygote normally forms with the 46th chromosome. It divides into 2, then mitosis 2 into 4, 4 into 8, 8 into 16. For example, during the last mitosis division, that is from 8 to 16, cell number 8, there is a problem with the division, and the resulting 15 and the 16 number cell contains the different number of the chromosomes. They may contain the one extra or the one less number of the chromosomes. So it is actually the almost 13-15% cells which contains the abnormal number of the chromosomes. Not all the population. It will be only the cells from that population of the cell, cell number 8, which divide into 2, forming the cell number 15 and 16. So all the cells from those 2 cells will be formed. They will have the different number of the chromosomes. So only that proportion will have the cells with the abnormal number of the chromosome. All the other cells will have the normal number of the chromosome. This is called mosaicism. Some abnormalities can be inherited from a parent, such as a translocation or be de novo, new to the individual. This is why chromosome studies are often performed on parents when a child is found to have an abnormality. Now we discuss the different trisomies. Trisomy may involve the autosomes, or it may involve the sex chromosomes. Trisomy of the chromosome number 21, 18 and the 13 are common. Sex chromosomes may involve, the cells may contain an extra sex chromosome. So it will be labeled as 47, and if it contains an extra X chromosome, then it will be labeled as triple X, and the individual will be female, and the incidence is usually 1 in 2,000. They will be mildly mentally retarded, and they will show the two sex chromatin bodies when we examine in the buccal smear or the WBCs. Similarly, sex chromosome may involve the male offsprings, and they will contain the two X chromosomes and one Y chromosome. And typical example is the Klinefelter syndrome. A male may contain the two Y chromosomes rather than the two X. So they may contain the two Y and one X. There will be the problem with the same, but usually those people are tall and they show all of the time an aggressive behavior. Now do we discuss the very important trisomy, that is the Down syndrome. And the definition, embryological rather definition, is that it is a developmental disorder caused by an extra copy of the chromosome number 21. Causes, most of the causes occurs during the process of the meiosis 1, that is meiotic non-disjunction, that during the meiosis 1, two members of the pairs move to the one location and the one pole does not get the chromosome number of that respective pair. So the one cell will contain the 24 chromosome and the other contains the 22 chromosome, and when that gamete containing the 24 chromosome get fertilized with the normal gamete of the other partner that is containing the 23, the resulting will be the 47 chromosome. In 4% of the Down babies, there may be unbalanced translocation. I have already told you the long arm of the chromosome number 14 usually gets detached from its chromosome and get attached to the long arm of the chromosome number 21. So that cells contain an extra genetic material, which is it is typical, not the trisomy, that does not contain the three cells, but may be containing the 2.5 equal to the genetic material containing to the 2.5 chromosome. 1% of the Down syndrome shows the mitotic non-disjunction, that is the typical example of the mosaicism. Here is the karyogram showing an extra copy of the chromosome number 21. Incidence of the Down syndrome increases with the increase of the maternal age. For example, if a female gets pregnant with age less than 35, the chances of the Down baby birth is 1 out of 2,000 babies. But as her age approaches 35 or beyond, the incidence increases. At 35, one every 300 child baby is the chance is the Down syndrome. And after 40, it is even 3 times more than at the age of the 35. Features of the Down syndrome: there is a growth retardation, there is a mental retardation, and very, very typical craniofacial abnormalities. The Down babies have flat face, depressed nose, look at this nose, depressed nose, slanting eyes, then the protruding tongue, small ears, and the brush field spots in the iris of the, these are the whitish spots which are present in the iris of the Down babies, that is at the peripheral margin of the virus, there is a more accumulation of the connective tissue, giving the white spots in the iris of the babies. The Down babies may show a single transverse crease, which is called the simian crease. Normally, when we look on our hands, there are two transverse creases. They may be complete or half one, but there are usually two transverse creases in a normal. But in case of the Down baby, there is a single transverse crease. Down babies may have a congenital defects in their hearts. They show hypotonia, also shows the intellectual disabilities with the trouble learning to walk, talk, and take care of themselves. Now, epicanthal fold and extra skin fold over the upper eyelid. And as there is a brush field spots, these are the whitest spots in the iris. Very beautifully shown in this diagram, the brush field spots. Diagnosis. A triple screen test, which is done on the pregnant female, usually during the 15 to 20 weeks of pregnancy, alpha fetoprotein and the unconjugated estriol is 25% low. And the third is the serum HCG, which is 2 times higher than the normal. So these three parameters are checked: alpha fetoprotein, unconjugated estriol, and the serum HCG. Another way of the diagnosis is the parental ultrasonography. Prenatal ultrasonography, during which the ultrasonographer noticed that there is a short femur length with respect to the age of the pregnancy. The baby's femur length is short with respect to its intrauterine age. He or she may also notice an extra fluid on the back of the neck, giving the knuckle translucency. Normally, there is a collection of the fluid on the back of the neck, but in these babies, there is an extra accumulation of the fluid on the back of the neck, which is showing as knuckle translucency. Choroid plexuses, which are present in the brain, they may show the cyst formation. Another way is the karyotyping, which is also the diagnostic test, because in this way you examine the chromosomal numbers and you can take the sample at different time of the pregnancy from different sites. For example, if you want to take the sample during the 10th to 10th week of the pregnancy, you will take the chorionic sampling. Chorion formation होती है, वो बाद में हम पढ़ेंगे इंशाल्लाह ताला। तो कोरियोन का सैंपल लिया जाता है अल्ट्रासोनोग्राफिक गाइडेड, और उसको फिर कैरियोटाइपिंग क्रोमोसोमल स्टडीज के लिए भेज दिया जाता है। अगर हम यही क्रोमोसोमल स्टडीज लेटर ऑन, यानी कि 15 टू 20 वीक्स के दौरान कराना चाहते हैं, तो फिर हम एमनियोटिक फ्लूड को एस्पिरेट करेंगे अल्ट्रासाउंड गाइडेड और उसको भेजेंगे फॉर क्रोमोसोमल स्टडीज। और if at the time of the birth we suspect that the baby is a Down syndrome, we take the blood sample from the perumbilical blood sampling by way of perumbilical blood sampling, यानी कि umbilical blood vessel से हम sample लेके उसको karyotyping के लिए भेज देते हैं। और more important is the clinical diagnosis, which is done from the typical features which we discussed during the last slide. Then what are the increased risks with these babies? That is the simian crease. these babies have increased chances of leukemia. They suffer from repeated and chronic infections. They have higher chances of development of the hypothyroidism. They show premature aging. On and off, they show gastrointestinal obstructions. They may have an early hearing loss. They may have eye abnormalities. But unluckily, we cannot do anything with these babies except to treat the symptomatic problems. For example, infection, hypothyroidism, when you get on and off the complications, you try to treat those complications. And another is the rehabilitation physiotherapy, as you cannot change the genetic makeup of these babies. Another trisomy is the Edwards syndrome, in which the cell contains an extra copy of the chromosome number 18. बच्चे मैं इसको ना पॉइंटर बेबी या चूंच वाला बेबी भी कहते हैं. ये यूजुअली डाई विद इन द 5 इयर्स. अब देखें, दैट इज द ऑक्सीपिटल बोन, इट इज पॉइंटेड. थोड़ी सी नोज भी पॉइंटेड होती है, चेस्ट का सेंटर भी पॉइंटेड है, ईयर का अपर पोल भी पॉइंटेड है, हील की बैक भी पॉइंटेड है. तो मैं इसको पॉइंटेड कहता हूं. अब हम देखते हैं इनके ऑक्सीपिट आर द बैक पार्ट ऑफ स्कल इज प्रोमिनेंट, दैट इज प्रोमिनेंट. डिस्प्लास्टिक डीफॉर्म्ड और मेलफॉर्म्ड ears shape is different from the normal. They have small mouth, small jaw, as there is a less development of the mandible bone, short neck, shield chest are short, and the prominent sternum, that the central bone is, which is called sternum, is prominent one, and the wide spaced set breast nipples. Clenched hand with overlapping of the fingers, flexed big toe and prominent heels. They show different types of the abnormalities feature. Patau syndrome, which is due to the an extra copy of the chromosome number 13. The incidence is 1 every 20,000 babies. They die in the first month after birth. Flexion of the finger, cleft lip, abnormality in the formation of the upper lip or the lower lip. They also have the neural tube and the heart defects. Neural tube defects reflects in the malformation of the central nervous system, and the heart defects may be different types. You have learned during the FSE the Klinefelter syndrome. It is the trisomy with respect to the sex chromosome, where the individual contains an extra copy of the X chromosome. Defective individual will show the frontal baldness absence. So there will be hair on the forehead also, but there will be spared hairs growth on the beard area. So poor beard growth, tendency to grow fewer chest hairs, less chest hairs, narrow shoulders like the female pattern. Breast development, there will be gynecomastia in large breast. Female type of the pubic hairs, that is the direction of the pubic hair will be upward rather than the downwards, which is a typical feature of the male. There will be small gonads and long legs. Now the monosome is Most of the monosomies are not compatible with life. One which is very familiar is the Turner syndrome, in which there is a missing one of the sex chromosome in case of females. So these are the female babies with karyotyping 45X mean. Here one X is missing. So it is the only monosomy which is compatible with life. Almost 2% chances hai inke survive karne ke. Chances hai non-distinction, meiotic bhi ho sakti hai aur mitotic bhi ho sakti. Mitotic ko hum aapko pata hai mosaicism kehte hai. There may be structural abnormalities which lead to the Turner syndrome. These babies show very important short stature, heart-shaped face. It is the heart-shaped face, low posterior hairline on the back of the neck, webbing of the neck, mean diameter of the different, at different position of the neck is different. Here it is less, but at the root it is more. So, ye hum isko webbing, chalar wali gardan bhi kehte hain isko, Urdu mein. There may be narrowing of the one, any segment of the part of the aorta, which is called the coarctation of the aorta. Broad chest with widely spaced nipples, increase angle called the cubitus valgus, small size gonads leading to the formation of the steak ovaries, which result in the amenorrhea and the infertility. Structural abnormalities may be due to the definitely chromosomal breakage. It may be caused by the different viruses, radiations, chemicals or the drugs. Partial deletion and micro deletions. Partial deletion will lead to a syndrome which is called the Kreidl-Chiari syndrome. Micro deletion, few contiguous genes are affected. Maternal chromosome is involved, then it is called the Angelman syndrome, and the paternal, if paternal chromosome is involved, it is called Prader-Willi syndrome. Another example of the structural abnormality is therefore Giles X syndrome. Kreidl-Chiari syndrome. These babies shows the cat-like cry. The problem is with the partial deletion of the short arm of the chromosome number 5. Here, the short arm of the chromosome number 5 shows some portion of it is as deleted. They show microcephaly, small brain, and the result will be the mental retardation. They will also have a congenital heart defects, different types of. Prader-Willi, मैंने बच्चों आपको कहा था कि अगर मेल में इन्वॉल्वमेंट हो तो क्रोमोसोम नंबर यहां पे कौन सा है, क्रोमोसोम नंबर 15, और उसका आर्म कौन सा है, लॉन्ग आर्म. और अगर यही क्रोमोसोम में एबनॉर्मलिटी हो पेरेंटल में, यानी कि फादर साइड के गैमीट में प्रॉब्लम है, तो वो रिजल्ट करता है इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द प्रैडल-विली सिंड्रोम. हाइपोटोनिया, लुक एट हियर, है कहता रबड़ की तरह ढीला डाला बच्चा होता है. जब हाइपोटोनिया होगा तो मसल्स कॉन्ट्रैक्शन दिखाएंगे ही नहीं. अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर इज द ओबेसिटी. दे विल हैव मेंटल रोटेडेशन, हाइपोगोनाडिज्म एंड क्रिप्ट ऑर्चिडिज्म, मीन undescended testes in case of male. So it is the chromosome number 15, and that had come from the parental gamete. its long arm shows a deleted portion. If a female gamete have a deletion problem with the long arm of the chromosome number 15, the result will be the Angelman syndrome. These baby will have mentally retarded. They cannot speak, show poor motor development. They are prone to unprovoked and prolonged period of laughter. इसको हम कहते हैं बगैर वजह के हंसना और हंसते ही जाते हैं लंबे अरसे के लिए कई के मिनट तक. That is why they are labeled as Angelman. Fragile X syndrome incidence is a 1 in 5,000. Long arm of the X chromosome is involved, second only to the Down syndrome as a cause of the mental retardation. These individuals show large ears, play blue iris, and the prominent jaw. In addition to the formation of the abnormal babies, other problems which occurs due to the chromosomal and the genetic defect is the spontaneous abortions. Most of the abortions which occurs, rather 50% of the abortions is due to the chromosomal abnormalities. The birth defect babies will be produced with the birth defect, 50% of the conceptions spontaneous abortion, as I have told you, and out of the 50% of the abortion, major chromosomal abnormalities are there. So overall 25% of the conceptions have major chromosomal defects. Abortus have commonly falling chromosomal abnormalities, that is the Turner syndromes, triploidy, and the trisomy 16. At this point, we conclude this lecture here. Thank you so much, dear students. I advise you, please listen these lectures and read these topics from your books during this pandemic time of the COVID-19. May Allah bless all of us with good health. Assalamu alaikum.